This video demonstrates how to take a transhumeral plaster impression using a combination of elastic and non-elastic plaster bandages. Begin by applying insulating cream to the axillary area. Prepare a nylon stocking to provide insulation and gentle compression. Then place it over the residual limb. Prepare two non-elastic plaster bandages. The anterior splint should extend from the lateral center of the residual limb to just below the clavicle. Each splint should be approximately 7 layers thick. The posterior splint should extend from just below the spine of the scapula to the lateral center of the residual limb. Then prepare a 6-layer connecting strip and place it over the shoulder to link the two splints. Next, define the trim line. Position it just below the acromion. Use the clavicle to mark the anterior boundary. And the scapular spine to mark the posterior boundary. Now transfer the MyoSmart electrode positions determined during Myo testing. Wrap the residual limb with an elastic plaster bandage to capture its volume. To mold the axillary region accurately, adduct the arm, then guide it forward and backward. Apply and shape both the anterior and posterior splints and connect them using the connecting strip. Use moderate, even pressure to create a proper fit and contour. Once the bandage material has fully hardened, open the joining piece. Apply firm pressure to the contact areas and mark the overlapping section. Finally, secure the overlap with an additional plaster bandage.